Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at creating animated GIFs on your Mac. So it turns out you can't create an animated GIF in tools that come with your Mac. You can't do it in iMovie. You can't do it with QuickTime Player. You can kind of sort of do it using Preview, but there's no options and you can't make it loop. So I won't even go into that. And of course you can install various sorts of software, a lot of command line things you can use in Terminal. But in the end, this seemed like the kind of task that you should just get an app for. So I searched in the App Store and I chose GIF Brewery, and I'm going to show you how to use that to create an animated GIF. So the first thing GIF Brewery wants is a video. So I'm going to give it this QuickTime movie that I took with my iPhone. And I'm going to open it up. Now this is a huge 1920 by 1080 video, so you're only seeing the middle of it here. So the first thing I want to do is get it down to a size where I can view it all on my screen here. So let's do a high quality resize here, and I'm going to resize it to 640 by 360. Now I can see the entire thing. And I can scrub through it here at the bottom. And let me go and pick a good spot for a start. I'm going to do here, and you can set the start, and then you can go here, and let's just pick a spot here and set the end there. Now we see the area that will be exported as a GIF. Now there's a bunch of other things here you've got as options. For instance, there's a bunch of filters here. I don't want to do those because I like the video just the way it is. I can go and add a caption to it as well. So there's a bunch of different things I can do. I can go into GIF properties here and change a bunch of different things. So this is going to create a 24 frame GIF no matter how long the video is here. But I could also say, forget that, just create 10 frames per second. So a longer GIF if I give it a longer segment. Let's leave it here at 24 frames per second. Frame delay at 100 milliseconds. So in other words, 10 frames per second will be shown. And I can do a bunch of different things here, including setting the looping mode to normal, reverse looping, or palindrome, which means it goes all the way forward to the end, then reverses, and then forward again, which could be useful in some cases. So once I get those what I like, I'm going to go and say create GIF, and it's going to actually create it and show it to me. It's not going to just export it. So here I can see it, and I can see the final size of it. So it's pretty big. For a lot of GIFs, what you're going to want to do is create something really small. So for instance, I can hit discard here. Let's go, and I think this will be good as a smaller GIF. So do a 320 by 180. And that should cut the size quite a bit. So when I hit create GIF now, I'm going to get something that instead of being almost 4 megs in size is just over 1 meg in size. And I'm going to save it out, and it will allow me to save it out as a GIF. I can give it a name. And now I get the file sent out. Since it already created it, saving it out only takes a second. So now to see the result, I can do several things. One is I can just simply look at it here in the Finder, and I can see it there. I could also drag and drop it to Safari, where you're probably going to want to upload it to, say, your Facebook page or something like that, and people can see the final version there. So a few things about animated GIFs. First of all, is it pronounced GIF or JIF? Well, I've always used GIF, so I'll just stick with that. But there's an ongoing battle about how to say it. So GIFs, whether animated or not, use something called a color palette. You see, in a normal digital image, like a photograph that you've taken, each pixel is represented by red, green, and blue values that can represent millions of different colors. So every pixel has its own unique color. But in a GIF, it's different. A GIF has a list of up to 256 colors, and each pixel has to be one of those 256 colors. So what happens when you create a GIF is the image is analyzed. 256 colors are picked out that best represent the image, and each pixel simply uses one of those colors. So you don't get quite the image quality that you normally would with, say, a JPEG. This means when you export an animated GIF, which is even worse because there's multiple frames of images there, these 256 colors, that restriction is going to make the quality a lot worse than what you might be used to, say, with an HD video. So when making an animated GIF, you want to make it as small as possible dimensions-wise, like say the 240 by 160 size rather than a huge HD size. And you also want to not expect to get the same quality you would with a normal video. But you are going to get a smaller file size for that, and of course you get the neat effect of being able to post it anywhere on a Facebook page or whatever and have it animate. So in making an animated GIF using a tool like GIF Brewery or something else, you want to make the image as small as possible while still getting the point across. You can also adjust things like the palette size. I was able to actually make this image smaller by going into the properties and saying instead of using 256 colors, only use 48. And it made something that was still pretty passable. And keep in mind the files are still pretty big. Even at a smaller size, I was able to get this down to about half a meg. And with my fast connection, it would only take a second to upload that half a meg. And if I saw one online, it would take a second for me to see it. But a friend of mine might not have as fast of a connection, and when they go to view the animated GIF that I tell them is so cool, they might get frustrated by delays. Or worse, if they're trying to view it using a mobile device and they have a slower connection or bandwidth limits, then they might not appreciate a larger file. So let me know if you found this useful. I'll include a link to this app in the description here at MacMost.com. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.